Is C sharp becoming a new F sharp? What do you think? The answer to that specific question is no, that was easy. But the question alone is uncovering an unpleasant level of misunderstanding of how C sharp as a language is evolving. C sharp is not just receiving new syntax. C sharp is receiving new practices with the proven track record of success in other areas of programming. Most of which is admittedly functional programming, but that is natural. What can I say? Functional programmers were right all the time. Nevertheless, when introducing functional practices into C-sharp, F-sharp becomes a natural source of syntax. So yes, in a way, C-sharp is looking like F-sharp, but that was never the point. In this video, I will develop a small model in parallel in C-sharp and in F-sharp, so you can compare them. Once you understand how we use C-sharp, the latest C-sharp 14, for example, you will see the syntax will suddenly begin making sense. Let me show you the code. I have two console applications here, one in C-sharp, one in F-sharp. Most notably, the C-sharp project is a .NET 10 preview project because I plan to use a new feature, extension members in particular. Still, there is almost nothing in these projects right now. You will see the Hello World message printed in C-sharp, and here is the corresponding Hello from F-sharp in the other project. Therefore, I'm starting this demo from a blank screen. We are in F-sharp, and I want to declare a type that will model a company with the identity and the name. This is how you do it in F-sharp. The corresponding declaration in the latest C-sharp would be a record type, again with two components, an integer ID and a string name. The record in C-sharp is literally behaving the same as the type in F-sharp. Let's continue with another type for the address, for example, an identity, street, city, state, and zip code. The corresponding type in F-sharp would be almost identical with a few differences in the syntax. But look what I just said. Addresses are the address list. Would that be the list of addresses? What do you think? Would it be an array of addresses? Or an immutable collection, such as an immutable list of addresses? F-sharp will do that in a way on its own. A lot of my initial freedom was apparently taken away from me. Here is something many programmers do not understand about object-oriented and functional programming. You can make, literally make, an object-oriented program which is a functional program. It doesn't go the same in the other direction. I might be tempted to even say that the best object-oriented programs have always been functional programs. So, if you look at the situation in that way, you will notice that F-sharp is essentially putting a constraint on .NET programs, such as C-sharp programs. It constrains you in a good way. Let's continue. Let's get back to F-sharp, where I will instantiate a few objects. And look what I will do. I will use a with expression, which already exists in C-sharp, to create a new company instance. Both instances are immutable. Everything is deeply immutable here without my intervention. The language is designed that way. Let's see how that looks in C-sharp today. And then comes the with expression in which I will append the address to the immutable list of addresses I already have. So out of all collections I could choose to put into the company, I chose an immutable list and eventually got the code that is literally the same as the corresponding F-sharp code. I have already prepared a complete video about collections and immutable collections in immutable classes in C-sharp, so please refer to that video for a detailed explanation of what happens here and why. things will become a bit more complicated now because I want to introduce a contact for the company, which can be a billing address, a shipping address, or a mailing address. This is how you declare that in F-sharp, and it is a well-known discriminated union type. We are still waiting for discriminated unions to come into C-sharp, and they will come soon, and they will look a bit like this here. The difference between a discriminated union in a functional program and an inheritance hierarchy in an object-oriented program is that the discriminated union is a limited set. In an object-oriented hierarchy of classes, the hierarchy is open-ended. You can add more classes to it at any level, and that is essentially a bad idea. Almost any concept you will ever model will have a limited set of possibilities from which you will choose. Why create a class hierarchy which is open-ended when you already know all the possibilities? That is exactly what discriminated unions do. Let's see how that goes in C#. We can utilize records to simulate a discriminated union. An abstract record would declare the type itself, and then a few sealed records would inherit from that, each declaring the components, the properties it needs. So far in this project, I was modeling types. It is an essential activity in any project. You still don't need behavior. You still don't need methods on any of these types. Methods will come, don't worry. You need the representation of concepts. What is a company? What is an address? What is a contact information? Then comes the behavior on these types. What do they do? Or if we want to still stay within the premises of functional paradigm, what do we do on the instances of these types? I will use the latest feature of C# from C# 14, extension members. They will let me extend the company type with a property getter. I want to extract the first billing address from the company object. It might not exist, so I'm using a nullable address type here, which is pretty much normal in C#. Please think about this implementation of the property, extension property, which I just made. Why is that property separate from the type itself? Why is it not defined on the type? The answer might surprise you. The property doesn't belong at the same place where the type is defined. What if we needed this helper property only to implement a portion of code that prints labels that we would stick on the packages and parcels that we send via post? Why would the type know about that? Why would anybody else know about that piece of functionality when it's only the label printer that needs it? Here is the revelation. I have renamed this class to Company Label Printing. And I'm adding another extension property I will call Label, which returns the array of strings. This is the complete implementation of a feature which would reside in a completely different component, different project, if you like. Again, nobody will depend on this code. Let's get back to Program CS, where I will instantiate that same company with two addresses. If I wanted to print the labels here, I would need to include that namespace before I can use that behavior. So only now do I have that label property available as I wanted to have it, and I will print the label on the screen. Here it is when I run the application. I have shown you how similar C# today can be to a regular F# application. Let me remind you, that the introduction of these principles and these practices into C sharp has essentially limited your options when writing code in C sharp. Start thinking why those limitations are good for you, and you will start seeing how good the new syntax really is.